March 15. It's a date that now rings with meaning for all New Zealanders.
NewsHub has been told by a number of sources that as many as 40 to 50 people have been shot dead at mosques in Christchurch.
As a nation, our hearts broke. Our innocence was shattered, as was the innocence of our children. But as a nation, we fought to hold on to what we cherish.
They have chosen to make New Zealand their home, and it is their home. They are us. The person who has perpetuated this violence against us is not.
Kim Hurring produced News Hub's coverage on March 15th. She was also the first reporter on the scene on November 13th, 1990, a date less infamous than the location. Ara Moana.
We were the first people to actually film people leaving the scene, and we managed to stop and talk to a few of them, and I, to this day, cannot forget the look on their faces.
David Gray went on a shooting rampage, killing 13 people and himself.
They were completely in shock. They had witnessed something unlike anything New Zealand had ever experienced before, and that's something that will always stick with me.
Between Ara Moana and March 15th, Hurring has been a journalist on some of the country's biggest stories, operating, as three often did, on the lowest budget.
We had nothing. We had no resources. You know, we had a camera and we had reporters. We had a few notepads. That was about it.
The seat of the pants approach came to a head in Gisborne in 2000.
The women in this inquiry have told 3 News they're anxious to meet him face to face.
There was one day I remember in particular where I was at the cervical cancer inquiry and the evidence was really heavy and serious, but suddenly had to spin on the head of a pin and cover Homer, the sea lion, that was humping cars on the wharf.
There was even a woman who decided he needed companionship. She came and sang to the creature and patted it. 30 seconds later, she was running for her life.
TV channels from all over the world hounded us for pictures of Homer, and it's still our most sought-after piece of vision. In TV, the pictures are God. How many New Zealand stories do you remember immediately when you see a particular image? The murder of David Bain's family. The murder of Mark Lundy's family. The collision of a helicopter and a plane over an Auckland motorway. The Christchurch earthquake that claimed 185 lives. The Pike River mine disaster that killed 29 workers. The disappearance of Ben Smart and Olivia Hope. Or the last CCTV shot of Grace Mullane alive. The Rena disaster. Shrek, the world's woolliest sheep. Stephen Joyce being hit in the face. And John Oliver's response. Some stories, though, it's not the pictures you remember, but a certain phrase.
An emergency defecation situation.
Or a particularly memorable sentence.
It's like Norman Bates dressing up in his mother's clothing. It's just a little bit creepy, and I feel like you're going to stitch someone's skin to your face and then kill everybody in the audience.
New Zealand, we've grown up together. We're probably not as wild now as we were when we were young. But then again, you probably aren't either.